Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to use implicit differentiation to find the equation of the tangent line at a given point. To complete this problem, we'll use implicit differentiation to find the first derivative. Then we'll plug the given point into the derivative to find the slope of the tangent line. Finally, we'll plug the slope and the given point into the point-slope formula for the equation of the line to find the equation of the tangent line. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to use implicit differentiation to find an equation of the tangent line to the curve at the given point. And as you can see, we have a function that's all tangled up in terms of x and y. We can't easily separate x and y, so we really need to use implicit differentiation to find the derivative of this function. Remember that the equation of the tangent line can be expressed in point-slope form, where we have the equation as y minus y sub 1 is equal to m times x minus x sub 1. Remember that we're looking for, when we have the equation of the tangent line in this form, we're looking for three values. We have y sub 1, which we can get from the point that we've been given, and that's already, we know, going to be 1/2. We have x sub 1, which again comes from the point we've been given, and so we already know that that will be 0. The only thing we really need to find here is m, and m is the slope of the tangent line at the given point. The only way to find the slope is by taking the derivative of the equation and then plugging the point into the derivative. So we're going to go at this problem in a couple steps. The first thing we're going to do is use implicit differentiation to find the derivative of this equation. Then our second step will be to plug in the point 0, 1/2 to our derivative, and then that will give us m. So once we have m, we can plug in x sub 1, y sub 1, and m to our equation of the tangent line. So let's go ahead and find the derivative of this equation. Remember that when we're talking about implicit differentiation, we're talking about taking the derivative of this equation with respect to x. So that's important because what it means is that when we deal with terms that have only x involved, we don't have to worry about the derivative. Taking the derivative, for example, of x squared with respect to x is the same kind of derivative that we're used to. The derivative is 2x, no problem. But when we take the derivative of something like y squared, we have to use chain rule and multiply by y prime because we have to treat y as a function. So here's what that looks like. We'll take the derivative of one term at a time, and the derivative of x squared will simply be 2x. The derivative of y squared, however, will be 2y, just as if y were the x variable. But because we're taking the derivative with respect to x and we have a y variable involved here, we have to multiply our result here by y prime. So the easiest way to remember this is just that whenever you take the derivative of something that involves y, you have to multiply by y prime, or the derivative of y. So let's see what that looks like on our right-hand side. So we have equals. Notice that we have a quantity here that's squared. That means that we have to use chain rule. And to use chain rule, we'll bring this 2 all the way out in front here, and then we'll subtract 1 from the exponent. So the derivative of this using chain rule will be 2 times what's inside. The square is part of the outside function. The 2x squared plus 2y squared minus x is the inside function. So we take the derivative of the outside, leaving the inside completely untouched. We don't touch it. So we get 2x squared plus 2y squared minus x. And that exponent goes away because we get 2 minus 1, which is just 1. So we took the derivative of the outside function, leaving the inside function alone. But now, according to chain rule, we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside function, which means that we have to take the derivative of what's inside now, 2x squared plus 2y squared minus x. So the derivative of that, term by term, and again, we're multiplying here, the derivative of 2x squared will be 4x because it's just x, nothing fancy involved with that one. But the derivative of 2y squared will be the same thing for y, except that we're taking the derivative of something that involves y, which means we have to multiply by y prime, and it's as simple as that. The derivative of negative x is just negative 1. Again, since y is not involved, we don't have to do anything special there, and we just get negative 1. So that's the derivative of the right-hand side, and now it's just a matter of simplifying. What we'll want to do eventually is solve for y prime. So we're going to need to get all of our terms that involve y prime on the left and everything that doesn't involve y prime on the right. So let's first go ahead and deal with this right-hand side here and multiply everything out. So we got 2x plus 2y times y prime on the left. And then over here, let's go ahead and distribute the 2 across this first term. So we'll get 4x squared plus 4y squared, minus 2x. And we'll be multiplying that whole thing by 4x plus 4y, y prime minus 1. Now again, we'll multiply those two terms together and we'll just be foiling here. So we'll take the first term and multiply it by the first term, then the first times the second, and the first times the third, then the second times the first, second, and third, etc. So 4x squared times 4x will give us 16x cubed. 4x squared times 4y, y prime will give us 16x squared y, y prime. 4x squared times a negative 1 will give us a negative 4x squared. Now we move on to our second term here, 4y squared. So 4y squared times 4x gives us 16x y squared. 4y squared times 4y, y prime gives us 16y cubed y prime. And then 4y squared times a negative 1 gives us a negative 4y squared. Now we have negative 2x here. So negative 2x times 4x gives us a negative 8x squared. Negative 2x times 4y, y prime gives us negative 8x, y, y prime. And then negative 2x times a negative 1 gives us a positive 2x. So now we can do some quick simplification here. Notice that we have a 2x on the left-hand side and a 2x on the right-hand side. They're both positive. They're the same term, so they'll cancel with one another. Now we want to combine terms as much as we can, and we also want to separate the terms that involve y prime from the terms that don't. So we have a 2y y prime over here on the left, so that takes care of that one, and I'll underline them as I go. Then I want to move this 16x squared y, y prime to the left-hand side because it involves y prime. So I'll subtract it from both sides and get negative 16x squared y, y prime. I'm looking for my next y prime here, and I see that I have 16y cubed y prime. So I'll subtract that from both sides and get 16y cubed y prime. And then I have this term here. I have a negative 8xy, y prime. So I want to add it to both sides, and I'll get plus 8xy, y prime. Those are all the terms involving y prime, so that's everything that's going to move to the left. Everything else will be left on the right-hand side. So I'll have equals 16x cubed, which takes care of this term. Then I have a minus 4x squared and a minus 8x squared. So these two will combine with each other to get negative 12x squared. Then I have a plus 16xy squared. So plus 16xy squared. And finally a minus 4y squared. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to factor out my y prime, or my first derivative of y. So I'm going to pull that out, and I have that multiplied by 2y minus 16x squared y minus 16y cubed plus 8xy. So notice I just factored that out, and that's still equal to this right-hand side. Now what I want to go ahead and do is divide both sides by this whole quantity here, 2y minus 16x squared y, etc., to get y prime on its own. So I'll get y prime is equal to the right-hand side, 16x cubed minus 12x squared plus 16xy squared minus 4y squared, all divided by what I had over here on the left-hand side. And now that I've solved for y prime, I want to go ahead and plug in my point 0, 1 half. I'll plug in 0 for x and 1 half for y and see what I get for y prime. So I'll get y prime equals 16 times 0 cubed minus 12 times 0
squared plus 16 times 0 times 1 half squared minus 4 times 1 half squared. And then in my denominator, when I plug in, I'll get 2 times 1 half minus 16 times 0 squared times 1 half minus 16 times 1 half cubed plus 8 times 0 times 1 half. And you'll notice I can go ahead and cancel everything with a 0 in it. So all these terms here will cancel, and I'll just be left with 3 terms that I need to focus on. So I can see that I'll have y prime is equal to, on the top here, negative 4 times 1 half squared will be negative 4 times 1 fourth. And in my denominator on the bottom, I'll have 2 times 1 half, which will just be 1. And I'll have 16 times 1 half cubed. 1 half cubed will be 1 eighth. So I'll have 16, negative 16 times 1 eighth. When I simplify this in the numerator, my 4s will cancel and I'll end up with negative 1. In my denominator, I'll have 1 minus 16 times 1 eighth. The 8 will cancel and I'll be left with 16 over 8, which is just 2. So I'll get 1 minus 2. Of course, this will simplify to negative 1 over negative 1, which is just 1. So what I found here is m. By finding the derivative and plugging in the point 0, 1 half, I found the slope of the tangent line at that point, so m equals 1, which means I can return to my tangent line equation and plug in the 3 values that I need. So y minus y sub 1, which I know to be 1 half from the point I was given, I know that m is 1, and I know that x sub 1 is 0, again from the point we were given. So now I just simplify this as much as possible. Y minus 1 half is equal to just x on this side, because I get x and then I get 0, x plus 0, or x minus 0, so I just get x. And then I can go ahead and add 1 half to both sides to get this into slope-intercept form. And I get y equals x plus 1 half. And this equation here is the equation of the tangent line to this curve, our original equation, at the point 0, 1 half.
So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.